morning, YouTube Nation.
I'll even say hi.
No? Okay. She's shy, or being shy. She's not shy. The weather's awesome outside. I'm gonna spend majority of my day outside. I'm gonna soak up as much sun as I can before it starts raining again. But right now, we're actually heading over to Lowe's to get a few supplies needed for the project that I have in mind for the day. Got a driver. Right. Squeeze. We're not gonna make it. There we go. Yeah. You like those? Let's get them. Put them in the buggy. There it is. That was fun.
All right, so I think we got all the supplies on the list that was in my head for this project. You know, I probably forgot something. I'm sure. It's typical. But luckily we can just run back to the store if we need. I got my supplies. Lila got her M&Ms. She's happy. So yeah, we're headed back to the house now. I'll go ahead and get everything together, and then we'll go over the plan. I will give you a hint. It has something to do with towing. All right, guys. So made it back to the house with all my supplies, and I guess now I'll kind of fill you in on what's about to happen. So everybody knows that we tow my wife's vehicle behind the RV. Pool lighting situation was kind of an up in the air thing. We were using these magnet lights, but it was just a hassle putting them on and running the wire across the hood, hooking it up. It just, I knew there was a better way. So I looked at like E-Trailer, Amazon, different places, and they make these kits where you can actually install these diodes in your wiring harness and use the brake lights and stuff on the car. But I didn't want to cut into the wiring harness, and the options other than that are limited, other than magnetic lighting. So what I did was is I came up with a plan in my head to use the magnetic lighting but make it simpler to use. So that's what I did. So we went to Lowe's earlier. You seen we got some supplies. Ordered some things off Amazon, but this is gonna be the start of a plug and play magnetic trailer lighting system. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the car moving in the garage here, and I'll kind of walk you through it as we go, see how it's gonna work. In my mind it works, so we'll try it. Okay, so I went ahead and stretched out my wire, kind of mock fit it and see how it's gonna all mount up. So you can see I have my magnetic lights here mounted on the top. That's normally where they ride. It's wide enough, you can stretch them a little more. But I just wanted to see how much wire I was gonna have left over, how much wire I needed. And I think that everything's gonna work perfect. So what I did was, is I ordered this 4-flat connection here. And what I'm gonna do with it is I'm gonna wire it up on the magnetic lights to give me something to have a way to plug and unplug. It's 4 foot of wire. So I'll cut my wire and splice it somewhere around here. And then my plug's gonna reach perfect to where I need to plug it in and out. And then I have all this excess wire here that will be added to this length to make up the difference there. So I'll be able to get all my wire back to the front. And I went to Lowe's and I got this Hopkins extension. So basically, all it is a male and a female on both ends. Here. So I don't need this end because I already have it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut that off, and then this will mate here with this one, and I'll tie this end to the existing wiring harness. It sounds kind of confusing, I know, but I'll show you once I get it all on there, and as I'm doing it, make it a lot easier to understand. But that's gonna make my permanent setup on the vehicle plug and play. Plug to the front, plug the my headlights to the back. You got two lights. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut that. And while I have it cut, I'm gonna go ahead and run the wire underneath with that dead end. It'll make it a little easier to pass it through everywhere. I'm just gonna kind of try and run it out the way. And I'm gonna use some 8-inch zip ties that I'm gonna use to secure it along the way on the frame of the vehicle. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and mock fit this extension plug here again, just to make sure I got enough. I don't wanna cut myself short and have to splice more areas than I have to. Just needed to reach the bottom there. So that looks pretty good. So I'll probably cut it, I guess, about right here somewhere. Give me a little extra wire. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. All right, so I got my heat shrink. I'll make sure I don't forget to cut a strip of that, slide it on before I splice everything up. But I'm just gonna take this in here. I'm gonna pull these wires back a little bit. That way I can splice each one of them. Go ahead and cut me a piece of heat shrink now. Slide that on there. And crimp on my butt splices. Got some 16-14 gauge blue butt splices. It's hard to say, blue butt splices. Get those on there. All right, go ahead and take my adapter end here, and we'll do the same thing on this end and splice it together. There's no worries. I mean, as long as you stick with the same colors front to back, I mean, everything's color-coded already, so no worries of crossing wires by accident, have brake signals going when turn signals are supposed to be going and stuff like that. You'll be good. All right, go ahead and get those spliced together. Go ahead and slide the heat shrink over that. I probably put a little too much heat shrink, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. Get both those ends covered up, keep them from getting any moisture in there, hopefully save us some trouble down the road. All right, I don't have a fancy heat gun, so I use the old faithful lighter. One day I'll get one, I guess. We're done with that end. So now we have our magnetic lights with our extension. So what we can do now is go ahead and run the wiring harness under the vehicle and get that all secured. And then we'll tie in the back. I don't want to tie in the back until we got it all in. Just make it probably easier to run. But I'll get underneath there and look at it and see. All right, so I got my main wiring harness stretched out here. And as you can see, we should have like perfect amount. Even got a little extra. All right, I'll go ahead and run down the other side and we'll cut it. Push my wire back. Go ahead and make my splices. I'm just gonna tape it. Make it easier to run too. Now we're ready to run it down the vehicle. So I got my wires ran up underneath. I'll go ahead and show you where I ran it, how I ran it. I didn't want to bore you with pulling wires through the frame and tie wrapping. It's kind of silly. Like I said earlier, every vehicle is going to be different. This is actually a Ford Expedition. It's a 2015 model. It's the EL model, I believe. I'll be doing a review in the next couple weeks, probably on the tow system that we have, our braking, our tow bars, how we hook up and all that. I had a lot of questions about that. And we're new to it as well, but we figured it out pretty quick. Me and my wife make a pretty decent team, so it goes pretty smooth. She's really good at lining it up. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and show you how I ran it. I ended up deciding to mount my connection here just to give me a little extra room with my extension cable. And it's gonna be clean mounted there. I got the bracket. We'll do that in a minute. But I ran my wire up through here, then came around underneath here, and then ran it up over the A-arm. And then from the A-arm, I ran it here and followed this wiring harness onto the running boards all the way down, then crossed over the back A-arm here. Crossed over the back there, you can see, and then came out right here by the spare tire, and it's gonna actually continue on and mount on the back by the receiver hitch. The reason I left it down is because we have to make our final connection for the magnetic lights hookup, and that's gonna be this this male end. So the magnetic lights here are gonna be sitting on the top, as we spoke about earlier. And then this will be hooked up to that wiring harness that's permanent here. So it'll mate up, come sa. So all I gotta do is cut this end off here, splice this in with the wiring harnesses there. Then I can go ahead and mount my brackets. The mounting brackets are here, Hopkins mounting brackets that I'd ordered on Amazon. I wanna say they were maybe $4 or $5 a piece. Nothing too crazy. Go ahead and show you those right quick. So it's pretty simple design. Actually comes with some screws, yeah, some self-tapping screws. I bought the stainless steel hardware to use instead, but I mean, you could use this hardware if you wanted. But basically what happens is you take this end here, you mount it in there, close it, snap it, and then you bolt this to your vehicle. So then you have a clean kind of look, like a factory install almost. And I'll probably get some dust cap covers for the ends to clean it up. And I will also get some type of wire protector to put on here. Probably some of that plastic coil that goes on there. It's gonna make that look a lot cleaner, and it's gonna protect those wires as well. I couldn't use the sock like the last one because this wire is already ran, and I didn't wanna cut and make more splices. In a wiring system like this, especially something that's exposed to the weather under the vehicle, less splices, best, man. You don't want to have all that moisture exposed to those wire connections, butt splices. And when you do have trouble, it's a lot harder to troubleshoot. You'll be fighting back and forth trying to find why you're having issues. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this and then get it spliced in. We'll take our mounting brackets, mount them where we want them, and that's gonna almost wrap it up. That'd be pretty close. Okay, so we got it all spliced in, and I'm thinking about mounting it right here. I think this is a good location, easy access. So I'm gonna go ahead and make me some pilot holes and use the hardware that came with it and drill it and secure it. Got it good and secure right there, and then the lights will plug in just like that. There we go. I'm gonna go ahead and get the front part of the wiring harness installed, and I'm gonna mount it right here. I like this spot right here. It's got some meat on it, pretty tough. Should do us fine. I'm gonna use my stainless steel hardware that I purchased, flat work. brush on the bottom. Alright, looks good. Flat washers on the top. I got some nylon lock nuts. That way it'll be on there, we don't have to worry about it no more. Be good and secure. Looks pretty good right there. Pretty even on both sides. Snug. So then my section from my camper to my vehicle, I plug in. Like that. There it is. So now I'll plug to my camper, and there you go. Be ready to roll, man. I like it. Makes it a lot easier whenever we're hooking up to toe-toed or flat toe. So there it is. Nice clean installation. Same thing in the back. There it is, nice and clean. Hook up your lights. You ready to go? Perfect. You get where you're going. Snag this off and hook the front. You're done. All right, so that's the end of today's DIY project. I hope this helps anybody if they had any ideas or were looking for ideas on lighting situations for their toads or flat toe rigs. I figured that it was probably my best bet. I did some pricing around for the diode kits in town, and it was $400 or $500 for the installs. And I just really didn't want to cut into the wiring harness of my wife's daily driver. I had the magnetic lights already. I mean, I'd seen no need to waste money on other things. All I bought was a couple of wiring harness ends and some brackets off Amazon, really. Tie wraps, basic things that you need. I mean, I probably have less than $100 wrapped up in this whole setup. The lights were $40 by themselves, and I even bought some tools. We're doing a full review of how we hook up, how all the equipment works, kind of give a rundown. Had some questions about that stuff here recently, and we'll do a test run with the lights to show you how easy everything's to hook up. So like I said, if you have any questions or comments, leave us something down below, give us a like. Hope this helps somebody. Until then, safe travels.